You know, it was a great experience for myself and the team to come out here to play in a historic stadium like this. It's always cool to come out here and experience new things. So, you know, it was a great opportunity.
Reggie, what was it like watching that field goal attempt for you?
You know, I was just speechless. I was just sitting there, you know, hoping that something went right for us, and it did.
Reggie, you lose the lead in the second half. Talk about how you gathered the guys and come from behind to win at a historic venue.
Yeah, you know, things went a little rough there for a minute, but, you know, we just kept our composure and knew that, you know, we were going to turn it back around and, you know, keep executing our game plan, and that's what happened.
Reggie, how far was Brandon running the ball? Just talk about his second half and how it kind of took a little pressure off of you.
Oh, yeah. You know, Brandon always does a great job, you know, running the ball. And, you know, the second half, he just, you know, he wanted the ball. So we started giving it to him, and he made plays for us.
Reggie, how cool is this one? I mean, you walked out, you won. First time you've ever played Notre Dame here. Starting quarterback. It's got to feel good, right?
Yeah, it hasn't even hit me yet. Honestly, I'll probably be in my dorm later tonight and be like, this really happened. So, yeah, it's a great experience.
Is this the kind of thing you dream about as a kid in the backyard? I mean, do you ever, like, have that in your head that you're going to lead the game-winning performance and all that, especially at a place like this?
Oh, yeah. I mean, growing up, I mean, I used to play football by myself, you know, just throwing in random spots and things like that. So, I think those dreams are coming true now, and, you know, hopefully just keep it going.
Reggie, how much was your dad on your mind tonight? I know you had a rough season, and you said you were going to dedicate this season to him, and that wristband on your destiny, I think you done a little bit for that tonight. How did that matter? Was he with you tonight?
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, I was talking to him throughout the game today. There for a minute, I was getting a little emotional around the third quarter, and it doesn't really happen a lot. So, yeah, I could tell he was with me, and, you know, start the fourth quarter, some reason I got the chills, too. So, I could feel his presence with me.
How do you not get emotional in a setting like this with all the hype?
You know, my parents, you know, they raised me, you know, take care of business when it's time to take care of business. So, you know, I just give credit to them and my family and also my teammates and coaches, you know, just keeping me focused and on track.
Did you feel composed all week?
Oh, yes, sir.
You getting nervous now?
Oh, no. You know, I had some butterflies just ready to start the game on the way here to the game.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, other than that, I was ready to play.
What about the fans? How much could you hear them and, you know?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Louisville represented today. You know, I'm not sure what the amount of fans there were, but they were loud. So, speaking on behalf of the team, we appreciate that. And, you know, we hope to see fan bases like that from now on.
What does this do for you confidence-wise, both as a talent and also for the rest of the team, in terms of where you stand in college football?
You know, it gives us a big confidence boost. We've never lacked confidence, you know, all throughout the season. So, you know, I think it just adds more confidence to the team and myself.
Reggie, they did a nice job on Devontae. Just talk about the way they did that. And you got some other guys into the mix.
Yeah, I mean, you know, they had a good game plan as well. So, you know, we had to go to other options and things like that. And, you know, the guys on the team stepped up.
What did you do with the ball? You kept the ball at the end of the game, right?
Oh, yes, sir.
What did you, is that in your bag?
Oh, yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah, you're not giving that to the coach?
Nah, the equipment. I might have to take that up with equipment manager.
Yeah. How many balls have you kept in your career?
It's my only one.
Really? None in high school?
No. No, sir.
Yeah. So this was pretty special.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Reggie, in games like this where the momentum keeps bouncing back and forth and you guys fell behind, you, what do you think for a player, for a whole group of a team, what does it take for you guys to kind of get the momentum back and get your heads right and get back in it?
It just takes a lot of focus, you know. At this point, you know, we knew that it was going to be a fourth quarter game. We knew they were going to come back eventually. And, you know, it's just about preparation and being focused and knowing what they're doing and throwing at us and, you know, just staying positive.
You had two pretty long touchdown runs in the first half. What did you see on those plays? What opened for you?
You know, they were just basic zone reads. You know, I read the defensive end. So he came down and I pulled it. And, you know, the receivers did a great job of blocking outside on the perimeter. Allowed me to get in the end zone.
Will was one of the first guys that found you after the game. What was this whole thing like, and how cool was it for him to be right there with you?
It was great. You know, we shared a couple of words together. I told him I loved him, and I told him I told him I was going to have his back, you know, before the game. So, you know, me and Will are real tight. So it was great to have him on the sideline, you know, right there with me